That is how you smoke a beer can of chicken.
Welcome back to Down South Cookin. Today, I'm gonna show you how to make some beer can chicken. It's fairly simple. All you need is a couple chickens, a couple beers, a little bit of seasoning, and a smoker. So, let's get started. So first things first, we're gonna start with our rub. It's a simple rub today. It's already mixed up, equal parts salt, pepper, and garlic. Got paprika for color. This is a lemon and herb seasoning with butter flavor. Amazing shit. Got some cayenne powder, because you know we love the heat. Splash of onion powder, not too much. It'll overpower pretty easily. So first thing, let's mix this up, make sure it's nice and mixed. And we'll probably do about 3 tablespoons of this. Basically a tablespoon of salt, tablespoon of pepper, tablespoon of garlic. Maybe a tablespoon and a half. Do a whole tablespoon of lemon and herb seasoning with butter flavor. It depends on your taste. I like it spicy. You may not like it so hot, but I'll put a whole tablespoon of cayenne pepper in here. And last but not least, get a little bit of onion powder in there, not too much. So, let's get this nice and mixed up. Smells good. Got nice color. The chicken's gonna come out looking beautiful. So now, let's prep the chicken. So, let's get started. So we'll put just a light little drizzle on each of them. Rub it around. Make sure they get nice and coated. Flip them over. Same thing to the back side. And you don't want to coat them in oil in the same pan you're going to season it in. If you do that, most of your rub is going to end up staying in the pan and not on the bird. So make sure you have a separate cutting board, cookie tray, whatever you want to use. So. Now we have our chickens nice and seasoned, ready to throw them on our beer cans, get them prepped, and ready to go in the smoker. You can choose any beer you like, whatever you prefer. I got some OE just because I'm from Southwest Houston and I thought this shit would be pretty funny. And they were cheap. The beer itself is not it won't impart a huge flavor. It will give some flavor to your chicken, but the big thing is it's going to help keep your meat nice and moist so your chicken won't dry out. So, usually, pop these holes open, drink them. I've let them warm up a little, so I'm not trying to drink any hot beer, so I'm gonna just pour out a little bit.
take them, you want to cut the tops off. That way you have more, I guess, it just better ventilation. So, you can do this however you want, with a knife, scissors. Just be safe. Fuck you barking at? So, take this, and a trick also, if you have a little bit of rub left over, put just a little bit of rub in them. It won't give much flavor, but anyone passing by, they're going to smell it. It's going to smell amazing. So that's one way to draw your customers in. So, sprinkle in there, sprinkle in there, and here we go. And Leah reacting in there all crazy. It's perfect. Alright, so I'm gonna give them one final little dust down with the rub. It's time to start the smoker. So we have the grates on the smoker cleaned up, got the firebox cleaned out, charcoal is looking about perfect down there, so time to throw it in the firebox and get it going. Let's close the door first, make sure nothing falls out. Using a mixture of lump charcoal and briquette. Didn't even know I had a bag of briquettes, so figured might as well use it. Don't let it go to waste. So I'll be back once the fire gets up to temperature. Alright, so we're about 300 degrees on there, y'all. So time to throw chickens on. I do have one trick to give you a little bit of a better presentation. Take the wings and kind of tuck them back a little bit. Either way, it's not the end of the world, but you know, it helps give you a little nicer presentation. Better even coloring on the breast and all. So it's time to just close the lid and just let them ride. We'll be back in a little bit. So we're about 30 minutes in, about 330, 335 on the temperature right now. So we're just gonna go ahead and turn them around, make sure they get a nice even cook. Oh yeah, they look beautiful. Nice and juicy. Spin the punches around. Leg don't get caught in there. We're about an hour, 15 minutes roughly into the cook. I'm gonna pop it open, check the temps, and see how they're looking. Damn. Man, it looks delicious. And while temperature is coming up to temp, I'm gonna show y'all what we're looking at right now. Tell me that does not look fucking amazing. Some beautiful birds right there. Where are we at? 144, 145. So we're close, you know. It's still rising up a little. I'd say we're probably about 150 right now. So, I don't know, about 15 minutes. No more than 30 minutes tops. They'll be done. It's eating time. I know Doja's ready. You hungry, girl? Hell yeah. Your bitch ass gonna get burned on that firebox. Alright, so stay tuned in. We'll be right back in a little bit. We're back. We're approaching the end of our smoke here, so time to check temps and see. Oh yeah. Fucking looks amazing. Let's check the thigh. Ooh, skin is nice and crispy. Look at this. Dripping out juice. Boy, I'm telling you, these chickens are gonna be amazing. Let's see where we at. Boy, we getting close, but still not quite ready. I'm gonna close the lid though, let it just stabilize and we'll see exactly where we're at. Looks like we're right about 153, so we still need about 10 more degrees. Let's check this other one. That one's about 150. So we still need just a little more time. We're done now with the cook. I just checked the temps. It's 167, so like 2 degrees over, but that shouldn't matter. Chickens look amazing. As I've been sitting here too, I came up with a name for them since we used some old English. I'm gonna call these hood chickens. Southwest Houston, hood chickens. Fuck it, why not? One more time though. Oh shit, we got the train coming, so it might get loud, so I'm gonna hurry up, but let y'all get one last look at these before we go inside. Tell me that shit does not look fucking amazing. That is how you smoke a beer can chicken.